This is a demonstration of the bubble sort, which is one of the most basic and also one of the slowest sorts. So what we've got here, we've got 8 blocks with numbers on them. And so our data set size or letter n would be 8. And if they are stored into an array, then the elements would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So the way the bubble sort works is there's an inner for loop and an outer for loop. So we're going to first execute the inner for loop. And what the inner for loop does is it compares each adjacent numbers to see if they're in order or if they're out of order. And if they're out of order, they swap. So let's first start with these two right here. These are in order. Let's look at the next two. They are out of order, so we swap them. And so now let's look at the next two. They're in order. Next two, they're out of order. Swap them. Next two, they're in order. Next two, they're out of order, so let's swap them. Next two, they're out of order, so let's swap them. And so now after one pass through, we're not yet sorted, but one thing that it has done is it's moved the largest block all the way to the end. So you could say that the block, which we're going to add to, will be the sorted section. So we really don't have to look at those again. So now the outer for loop says, do the inner for loop again. So let's make the next pass. And so now we look at these two. They're in order. They're in order. These two need to be swapped. These two are in order. These two need to be swapped. And so there we go. Now let's go to the next pass. So these two are in order. These two are out of order. In order. In order. So let's do it again. These two are in order, in order, in order. So we're actually already finished, even though it would have made a couple more passes. So that is the bubble sort.